Good evening. Welcome to Our Lady of Grace as we celebrate our Holy Thursday Mass. All of our music and responses can be found in your worship aid. We just ask that you please leave these in the pews for the next liturgy tomorrow afternoon. Please join in singing our processional hymn, Lift High the Cross. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. May the grace and peace of God our Father, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, and the love of Christ our Savior be with you all. My brothers and sisters, let us enter into this celebration commemorating the institution of the Eucharist by humbly acknowledging our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, who have called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the Church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love. Grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, It shall join the nearest household in procuring one and shall share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month. And then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand. You shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt, I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution. The word of the Lord.
Blessing cup is a communion with the blood of Christ. Our blessing cup is a communion with the blood of Christ. How shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me? The cup of salvation I will take up, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. Our blessing cup is a communion with the blood of Christ. Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. I am your servant, the son of your handmaid. You have loosed my bonds. Our blessing cup is a communion with the blood of Christ. To you will I offer sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. My vows to the Lord I will pay in the presence of all his people. Our blessing cup is a communion with the blood of Christ.
Thank you. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and, after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way also the cup, after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes." The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to hand him over. So during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing, you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever had bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason, he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that I have done for you, you should also do. The Gospel of the Lord.
My brothers and sisters, welcome to this great feast, the great banquet of love that we as Catholics know as the sacrifice of the Mass, Holy Eucharist, instituted by our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, in the upper room. This Holy Thursday, we gather to commemorate the institution of the Mass, the Lord's Last Supper. And in doing so, as faithful Catholics, we reaffirm our belief in the sustaining presence of Christ in a sacramental way when we seek communion with him and receive his body and blood. Tonight, a word of welcome to Father Ephron. Perhaps you thought Father Frank had some kind of cosmetic surgery, but no, it's not Father Frank, it's Father Ephron. He is one of the new three Filipino priests who have come to our diocese recently, and I invited him to share the sacred Paschal Triduum here at Our Lady of Grace. I thought it was appropriate, since you've been so gracious in welcoming Father Frank into ministry at our parish, and part of Father Ephraim's transition during this time of indoctrination is to sort of take some baby steps into having Mass in America, in the United States, in our beloved diocese. The Eucharist is about welcome. Each of us have been welcomed into God's family by virtue of baptism, whether by our choice as adults or being born into a Catholic family presented to the waters of baptism as an infant. We have all been welcomed into a family that believes in the teaching and the love of Jesus Christ. And this love is no more clearly celebrated than when we faithfully gather as his people around the altar to celebrate Mass. You who come this Holy Thursday evening to commemorate the institution of the Eucharist, the Lord's Last Supper, are integral part of the Church, of our Catholic Church Universal, of our parish family of Our Lady of Grace, your individual family community, marking yourself out, being identified as disciples of Jesus in our Catholic Church. Part of the Lord's Supper in the Gospel of John is highlighted. We hear that proclaimed in tonight's passage, where John emphasizes the fact that during the Last Supper, the Lord and teacher rose from the table, took off his outer garment, wrapped a towel around his waist, took a pitcher and a basin of water, and washed the disciples' feet. A living sign, a living example for his disciples and in turn us as well, that when we come to the table, as Catholics we so often focus on whether or not we are worthy, whether or not we are in the state of grace, for we seek to live a life of purity and holiness in communion with God. Particularly during the season of Lent that has now come to a close, we have focused on our need to repent, to change our life, to put our sinfulness behind us, and to allow ourselves to become worthy partakers in Holy Communion. But there is another aspect of sharing in this banquet of love, is that when we receive communion worthily, we commune with Christ and the Holy Spirit that fills our minds, our hearts, and souls with a commission, a mission to leave our family to go forth and proclaim his good news. Christ's love is the foundation of the church, the foundation of our parish, the foundation of priestly as well as lay ministry as his disciples. Last year, you may call, as the first time I presided at the Lord's Supper here at Our Lady of Grace, the officers of the St. Vincent de Paul Society came and had their feet washed. Thought a very important example of how our parish community reaches out to the poor, to allow the love of Christ that nourishes us here at the table and the altar, to take it to those who are in need of basic service, basic sustenance in food. Tonight, another group of parishioners will have their feet washed, a representative group of ministers of Holy Communion, extraordinary ministers of Holy Communion, whom we so often visibly see in the sanctuary at Sunday Mass, helping us to distribute the body and blood of Christ to one another. But many of them choose to also take on a mission, to take the sacrament of Eucharist to the homebound, to the infirm, to those who cannot physically be with us. Those extraordinary ministers of Holy Communion take their ministry just not in a liturgical sense, but that added sense of service, to understand that anyone who is Catholic is part of our community and deserves reception of the sacramental presence of Christ, to assure them that they are not abandoned nor forgotten, but they continue to be connected in a spiritual and sacramental way with our family. This night, as we celebrate the institution of Holy Communion, let us realize that our sharing in this great banquet of love is an invitation from God above to be a people of welcome, to be a people who bring healing and unity among people, and to be a people that believe in the graciousness of God's love. Watching the news this morning, I was certainly touched by a very beautiful story of a young family who, like all too many families, have a challenging child who was diagnosed with autism. And this mother was interviewed of the challenge of raising her son. It became almost impossible for her and her family to go anywhere. They were Catholic. And it even came to a point where they were no longer able to come to church because they felt as though everyone was watching them or they were a distraction. This mother was at wit's end. She came upon help and healing in a very unique way that I wasn't aware of. We're familiar with dogs who help the blind see, seeing eye dogs, but they've also found that a pet, a dog, can also be very healing for children with autism. That somehow this son was bonded to this dog, was able to return to school, was able to take walks to the park. A mother and father, as well as his siblings, were able to become family again, even to the point where the mother shared and gave witness to the fact that they returned to church. And when they returned to church, the priest invited the young boy, who had been away for a couple months, to come forward and was very welcoming to him and asked him to share his name and to introduce to the community the dog's and the dog's name. A very profound story of healing, of seeing how peace and comfort can be found in the most mysterious and unassuming way. That story captures the spirit of what we must be about as servants of Christ, as disciples of the Lord, with a mission to be welcoming. It is the mission that our Holy Father Francis has given to the Church Universal, that this table in which we share the body and blood of Christ can never be a place where we judge one another,
but rather a place where all are welcome to experience the immense love of a Heavenly Father revealed to us in the life and ministry of His only begotten Son, who embraced the cross for our salvation, to heal us, to bring us forgiveness, and to allow us to minister to one another. May we renew our belief and the power of the Eucharist we share this night, for as Catholics it sustains us on our pilgrimage to the kingdom, as well as our efforts to build that kingdom of peace, of love, and of healing as we journey toward that kingdom.
As I have loved you, yield to one.
Will you please stand? Grateful that we are called and invited to drink from the cup of salvation and receive the bread of life, let us offer our prayers and petition to our loving Father in heaven.
Our response will be, loving Master, hear us. For all the members of the church, may their devotion to the Eucharist bear good fruit in the form of humble service to others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Master, hear us.
For those who hunger for salvation, may their yearning be satisfied through placing their faith in Jesus and being nourished by the bread of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Master, hear us.
For those who feel lonely and forgotten, may they come to know the love of God through the care and concern of committed Christians. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Master, hear us.
For our faith community, may we give evidence of an authentic Eucharistic spirituality through our vibrant worship and our commitment to service. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Master, hear us.
For our elect, may these final days of preparation before receiving the Easter sacraments bring them many blessings. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Master, hear us.
For the men and women who serve in the military, that they may know that we hold them in our thoughts and pray for their safe return home. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Master, hear us.
For all those prayers we hold deep in our hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Master, hear us. Heavenly Father, hear our prayers and bless us as we strive to lead lives of humble service to others. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Hold this right there. Thank you.
Oil of the sick.
May the sick who are anointed with this oil experience the compassion of Christ and his saving love in body, mind, and soul. Through anointing with this oil of catechumens, may our catechumens who are preparing to receive the saving waters of baptism be strengthened by Christ to resist the power of Satan and reject evil and temptation in all its forms. Blessed be God forever. Through anointing with this perfumed sacred chrism, may children and adults who are baptized and confirmed, and presbyters who are ordained, experience the gracious gift of the Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever.
Thank you.
you. I'm going to let the incense burn. Just wait.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and good of all of his holy church. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy. Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church, be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Lawrence, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day on which our Lord, Jesus Christ, was handed over for our sake, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious, ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints, we ask that, through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer for our salvation and the salvation of all that is today, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest, Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, We ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through participation at this altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember, Lord, also your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. We dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours,
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. saving cup we shall hold high and call.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet for all eternity, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Would you please kneel? Okay, that's good.
Thank you.
When our